First off, I'm going to right click and edit this slide, and we're going to turn this into a bulleted list and turn that into an underline. So let's go ahead and we're going to do just that. I've presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to do both a bulleted list reveal and fill in the blank on the same slide. Hi and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever been in a situation where the pastor goes, okay, we want to do these bulleted lists, one right after another, and then in the middle of this bullet, there's a fill in the blank. Can you do that? And you've thought, actually, I don't know that I can. Well, I'm going to show you a little trick so that you can in this one. If you've had that issue, go ahead, tell me about it in the comments below, and like, subscribe, and share this with someone who might find it interesting. So from time to time, this does come up where a pastor will want a bulleted list where it'll reveal on one slide, and in the midst of that slide, it'll have a fill in the blank. So how can you do both on the same thing? Well, you might think that there's an option in ProPresenter, but I haven't found it if it is. So we have to get a little creative in how we do it. This is kind of an updated version of a tutorial I released a few years ago that I called Builds the Old-Fashioned Way, but that wasn't immediately obvious what that was about. So you may not have searched for it. So let's head over to the computer and we're gonna go through this just a little bit. So let's find a service here. Come on. I think maybe playlist here. If not, I think I'm going to... Yeah, I'll just go ahead and import the sermon that I've written for this purpose. So file, import, file. And by the way, this is, I know that some pastors are big fans of PowerPoint, but this is what I would do, is I would have, if there's scripture, put the reference and the translation. If there's a quote, put it in quotes. If there's a bulleted list, just give me a text file with the bulleted list. If it's just a regular text file, you can't put bullets. You need at least a rich text file to do that. Well, hyphens will do it. For underlines, put underscores if it's a regular text file, or underline it, whatever. If it's a video, tell me what the title of the video is, what the start and end point are, and put that in parentheses so I know that. Same thing for an image. So I'm going to go ahead and bring that in. So file, import. And since it's already separated, paragraph break, delimiters per slide, one, and then just pick an appropriate theme. I think this larger text theme is probably going to be a good one. And I'm going to bring that into sermon and then into the current playlist. So I've already done that. So let's make a new version. And with that, right here is what I want to deal with. So I'm going to click down here for easy view mode just to make it a little more visible to you. Actually, I don't like the way that looks. So let me go here and I'm just going to make it a little bit larger just by doing this. Okay. So now you see what we have to deal with. Well, first off, I'm going to right click and edit this slide, and we're going to turn this into a bulleted list and turn that into an underline. So let's go ahead and we're going to do just that. I've highlighted all that and I'm going to left justify it. I'm going to get rid of these hyphens because we don't need those anymore. And I'm going to turn this. Actually, before I do that, I'm going to, for this, I'm going to squish this down. So this is going to be obvious why I did that here in just a second. So right there. And also here under text, I'm going to make this top justified. You'll see why here in just a second. So now that I've got that.
Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to tdm.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person.
Let's highlight that. We're going to click this checkbox for list, and now it's a bulleted list. And for this earn, we're going to get rid of the underscores, highlight that, and click on the U. I could have done Command U on a Mac or Control U on Windows. That would have done it. One thing while I'm here, I have a stroke around these letters, and so as a result, ProPresenter uses that color for the underline. I don't like that, so I'm going to change this here to custom underline color and change it to white so that it's correct, which is the way that I think it should be. But we're good to go. We've got both bullets, and we've got an underline here. So how do we do the bulleted list reveal? Well, we go over here to build, add build, select a transition, cut is fine, dissolve, whatever you want to use. And so with that, oops, I should have selected that first. So add, build, cut, sorry about that. And then where it says delivery, change that to by bullet. And you'll notice that I can only choose one of those at a time. I can only do underline or by bullet. So first thing I'm going to do, by the way, while I'm here, is I'm going to click this first thing so that this comes in with the slide. Right now it says on click. I'm going to change that to with slide. And so the first one, proof of God's love, will come in with the slide. And then if we go back here to show, you'll notice we've got these three right here. And I do like that. That's good. Or if I right click and let's go to edit slide, and I select that again, and I change that to underline, and we go back to show mode. Now, if I click on this, and now notice that it has the fill in the blank ready to go, and if I click it again, then that fills in. But I can only do one or the other. So how do I get around that? Well, first off, what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click here, select copy, and then Command V on my Mac, Control V on Windows to paste. So let's do that for four of those. Now I'm going to go right click in quick edit, and I'm going to get rid of everything other than the proof of God's love. Right click, quick edit, get rid of everything other than the first bullet. Right click, quick edit, everything except the second bullet. And then this last one should be as is. So, first off, this transition, that was on me for not highlighting the text box. So ignore that. That's a mistake. But let me show you what it looks like now. Now, it looks like a bulleted list reveal when, in fact, what's going on is I'm changing slides. I will tell you that for this to work, the transition needs to be a cut or a dissolve. If you do any other transition, it's going to give away the secret. So if you did a cube spin, for example, it would cube spin between these two, and it just, that would give it away. So you do not want to do that. But now notice it did bring in the last one. So just to show you. And it's ready for the fill in the blank reveal. And so there we go. So that's how to do that. How to do both a bulleted list reveal and a fill in the blank at the same time. If you like this content, you would probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.